What if I was to tell you how the Force, so powerful, it can take you forward in life, success building upon success. With each achievement, your chance of further achievement grows. This Force can also drag you down, pulling you into negativity and self-destruction, making it harder and harder to progress in life and pulling you further down. This is the law of momentum. It can have a profound effect in your life, and its awareness can be very effective in taking you forward, or indeed backwards in life, if not used correctly. So, momentum means that when you move in a certain direction, the world or the universe or life wants to keep you moving in that direction. Now, this may sound familiar because this is actually acknowledged in physics. It's called Newton's first law of motion, the law of inertia. And this states that a body in motion will stay in motion unless acted upon by an external force. For anything, if you observe anything that is moving, the reason that it comes to a stop is actually because of gravity or air pressure or friction moving in the opposite direction. But if there isn't anything else, it will just keep moving. And that is similar in your life. If you go in a particular direction, you may feel a certain momentum come behind it, pulling you even further and further in that direction. Success breeds success, failure breeds failure, wealth breeds wealth, poverty breeds poverty, happiness breeds happiness, and sadness breeds sadness. This is acknowledged in ancient religious traditions and philosophy. In the Bible, it is stated, "For to everyone who has, more will be given, but from him who has not, even what he has will be taken away." So they are the two sides of the positive and negative momentum. Likewise, in Eastern traditions, they talk about karma. And karma simply means whatever you put out into the world will be given back to you. And there are consequences for your actions. So this realization can be observed in daily life, and when you observe the life patterns of other people across time. So, for instance, you may notice that people who have an abundance of social connections find it easier to have more social connections, and those who do not have social connections struggle even to get one. Similarly, you may notice when you are a young person, say starting off in the workforce in a field or something, actually your first step is the most difficult. When you start a business, your first client is the most difficult because you don't have any credibility. But once you have one client, it's easier to get two and so on and so on and so on. Similarly with money, those who have money will find it easier. Because they can save, they're not affected by a bad incident that might take them to debt if their car needs to be replaced, and that's a sudden cost. They can absorb it, or alternatively they can invest money, and that breeds more money. So it's very powerful. It also applies to success in general. It's widely observed, for instance, in sports and business, that there are parallels with people who are say, successful in sports, and they're used often to go on to become successful in business later on. So what I want to, I suppose, take from this discussion and introduce is that the awareness of this law can be transformative in your life. And I first want to talk about negative momentum. I think this affects a lot of people. If you are struggling some way in your life and you're trying to fix it, it's worth bearing in mind that the negativity that you're dealing with has a momentum of its own. It's not just the case that you are capable, say, of expending effort, like you're engaging in self-improvement. They're saying, I'm going to try and improve every day. Unfortunately, your habits, it could be an addiction, it could be self-sabotage, it could be anxiety or something, they're pulling you further back, and they can pull you further and further into problems. Take something like anxiety, for instance. It's widely noticed that for people, let's say you have agoraphobia, which is the fear of going out in public places, one of the things that they experience is that the phobia causes them to avoid going out in, let's say, a supermarket, say a busy place. But once they stop going to the supermarket, just simply walking down the street becomes difficult now. And then they avoid that. And then once they stop going down the street and they stay in their house, suddenly they're now actually anxious in their own house. Okay, so this law of momentum is very important to be aware of, and it's very important to harness. An awareness of negative momentum, I think, is necessary in your life. People who struggle with addictions might think, you know, I've been trying to give up smoking for 3 years now, and I still smoke. Well, if you are gone from smoking 40 a day to smoking 25 a day in that period, you should knock that progress, because actually the trend, if you had kept smoking, probably was that you'd be smoking 50 a day now, because you pushing back against that momentum, that negative momentum that you have, is actually a good thing. And if you decide, oh, what's the point, I won't bother, you will soon be smoking 50 a day. So when it comes to negative momentum and problems and habits that you have, I think it's why speaking about problems, journaling about problems, finding safe people, going to therapy, going to groups, they can be so effective, because you can confront the problem and you can seek external support that will take the momentum in another direction. The social momentum, the reinforcement that comes from an outside person reinforcing to you that it's important that you deal with your smoking addiction or your agoraphobia or anxiety or something, that gives you that push to take you in the direction of positive momentum. And you shouldn't knock any small gains that you have, because over time they can become very, very valuable. This momentum can then turn to positive momentum. The person who struggles with social anxiety, one time makes small gains in their life, overcomes it, builds a circle, say a friendship circle or a social circle, that can actually bring people further in your life. And that's a tipping point. So it's like a curve, right? You're trying to go up on the curve on one side, and then later, once you hit a tipping point, that momentum works in your favor. Okay, so it's about being patient when you're in a period of negative momentum, right? Making those small gains that can pay off in a big way in the future. And you have to have a certain level of a leap of faith. But I can get to that tipping point. It's easier then. And you can really ride that wave of momentum. Get onto that side of that ancient maxim in the Bible. To those who have more, be given. And even if you're really in a difficult place, even taking that step of trying to improve, you are acting on the assumption that I have or I can have something. And then that starts to work in your life. More will be given to you when you move in that direction. One of the interesting things about life is we don't really have a choice as to whether we move forward. You are going to move forward in life one way or another. I think it's going to happen to you in life, whether it's going to take you forward or backwards. You're going to be moving in life. It's like life is like being on a bicycle. In order for it to function, it has to be moving. It doesn't happen if you stop, it will fall over. So you're going to be moving one way, but it's up to you to decide what kind of momentum is going to be acting on your life, positive momentum or negative momentum. So that's the law of momentum, and I would like to maybe elaborate on that again, and that's it for me today.